Konnichiwa, YouTube. I just got through watching The Accountant with Ben Affleck. Rented it. I was really looking forward to this movie because it does feature a hero, anti-hero lead who has Asperger's or high-functioning autism, more probably. You do have to make a distinction between Asperger's and high-functioning autism. High-functioning autism, you're going to have more symptoms as a child that are going to be diagnosed these days, such as language delay, speech delay, sensitivity issues, and, you know, learning problems. And those under high functioning, if they're high functioning, a lot of those will go away. And by the time the individual is like 12, he will be almost identical to a person with Asperger's syndrome. It's just that the person with Asperger's syndrome will not have been diagnosed because there is no learning problem. There is no, by definition, and there is no language delay. So he would have had to have been diagnosed behaviorally. And that, even today, doesn't happen a lot of times. If there is no behavior problem, there would be no reason to do a diagnosis or put the child in special ed. But so this is an action movie. I'm not big on action movies of late. They've been pretty terrible. My idea of a good action movie is the original Die Hard or Lethal Weapon or The Siege, Oliver Stone movies, or Quentin Tarantino movies, or the movie Drive was good. I just don't like a straight out shoot 'em up with no atmosphere at all. Sometimes they're really awful and drive me crazy, like the Bourne movies, those with the shaky cam and the constant action, and it drives me into aspie overload. But this wasn't quite that bad on the action angle, but it was not quality action. The movie does try to present the autism correctly, but there's not a lot of that. And Ben Affleck is 44. He's 1 year older than me. He would not, in the movie, he doesn't have many symptoms. These are light symptoms that he has. He certainly wouldn't be diagnosed as an adult. And being my age, they wouldn't have known a lot about a mild autism at that stage when he was a kid. Because he did have a lot of meltdowns, maybe he would have been diagnosed. I don't know. But I don't buy Ben Affleck as a someone on the autistic spectrum or an assassin killer or even an accountant. It just doesn't. He's more like a frat guy. But I did buy him as a weak, simple husband in Gone Girl, a much better movie. That's the best movie he's ever done. I mean, he has done a lot of good stuff. Good Will Hunting is way overrated, but Gone Girl is awesome, about a marriage meltdown and a wife who distorts reality to get back at her husband, and the world takes the distortions for reality, and how perceptions of reality can be more attractive to the public and us than actual reality. The dangers of creating that fake persona or reality. I think it's a much better movie than this. But on to the autism elements of the movie. There's no romance in the movie. The Kendrick character is introduced. There's no romance. The plot is convoluted and unbelievable to the point of editorial negligence. Just not a good movie. But I did like the idea of having a lead character that incidentally is on the autism spectrum, but it doesn't play into the plot. But it's not very believable that he would be socializing all over the world with dangerous drug dealers and high-end money launderers. And I mean, he really has no symptoms as an adult. And some people with high functioning autism don't have a lot of symptoms. I mean, it is such a broad spectrum. Everybody's different, and there's no two cases alike. And they might should have put that in the movie to make it more clear, because the problem with movies about autism, and there haven't been many, but that Rain Man, it presents such a vivid picture of one person that people assume that everybody's like that. In that case, a savant, a numbers genius, like in this movie where Ben Affleck is a numbers guy. I'm a slight numbers guy. I like math. I've worked for a software tax firm before, and I like taxes. I wish I was would have been an accountant. I think I would have made a good CPA. But this movie just doesn't work for me on really any levels. The other movie about autism, Adam, back in 2010, of a guy with Asperger's syndrome, and that movie was the first movie that caused me to think that one of my ex-girlfriends, who was actually a highly educated therapist, that said I did have Asperger's, that maybe she was right. So that movie got some things right, but it totally exaggerated and put a stereotype out there that Aspies are totally unemotional and unfeeling, and that's a misconception, and I think it's been put to bed in the public mind since that movie in the last few years. But there aren't many good depictions out there, and certainly I don't know. If people like the action movie, maybe it's still a good thing to have the depiction of the autism spectrum on there to raise awareness or whatever. But I think I'd like to see better movies. Certainly, if I was making it, I would have played up the romance angle and gotten to his backstory through that way, dropped the convoluted plot, and had in my action movies, I don't want a lot of a convoluted plot or constant shoot 'em up. But so the movie's a mess. Anyway, konnichiwa.